Today we're doing a performance check on the 98 Audi A4's AEC system. First thing we're going to do here is turn it on, crank it up, and we're going to see how cold it's blowing. We're going to turn the pan all the way up. The temperature as low as it'll go. We're going to take a look at this thermometer here and see how hard it's blowing out. So it's blowing out 75.6 degrees, which is pretty much the ambient air temperature, so it's not cold here at all. So let's take a look at the gauges. We don't have any pressure. I'm actually still holding the vacuum from earlier. And if you can hear, the compressor is actually not kicking on either. So we're having absolutely no cooling effect. So what this is going to look like here is maybe we don't have enough Freon in the system, making the compressor not turn on, making no pressures in the line. So let's go ahead and see if we can't put some Freon in the system real quick. See if it will blow a little bit colder. We're always going to charge it to the low side because that's how we were taught, and that's just the better side. While we're waiting for this to charge up, we're going to talk about the importance of having proper Freon in the system. You always want to look at your manufacturer specification, because if you're running too low on Freon, your compressor may not kick on, you may not have any real cooling effect. And if you have too high of Freon, your pressures will be too high, and your cooling, the pressure differential won't be high enough. And that's what really causes most of the cooling effect in the refrigeration system. So you want to have the proper amount of refrigerant so that it actually has a good pressure difference from the high to low side past the orifice tube or expansion valve, depending on what kind of system you have. Making sure you have the proper amount of refrigerant is going to make sure you get the most cooling effect possible. So it's still charging the system here. Another reason why you may not have refrigerant in your system, as it is a closed system, you shouldn't lose much more than maybe a half a pound a year. That's going to be mostly off your compressor. If you're losing Freon, it means you most likely have a leak in the system, and the best way to find the leak is pour some fluorescent dye in through your low side, and you can use a black light and some goggles, and it'll be really very clear cut where the leak will be, as it'll blow really bright through wherever it's leaking out at. Another way to know if you may have a leak is by checking your gauges when you pull a vacuum and make sure that it does hold a vacuum indeed, which this is, so our system is probably good. Now it's getting ready to charge the system up. I don't have a whole lot of refrigerant in this machine, so I'm not going to be able to put the proper amount in. Hopefully it will be enough though to kick on the compressor, and maybe we can see a pressure differential, and maybe get some cooling effect, hopefully. You always want to make sure you put the proper oil in the system. Some systems are PAC, some systems are PO. You want to make sure that you're putting the correct oil in the system, as those are specific for manufacturing. This is an R134 system. Some are R12 older models. 134 is what everything is going through right now. It's cleaning up the environment. It's destroying the ozone layer, which is really good because, you know, global warming is a real thing, and we want to stop that. So we're still blowing out 75 degrees out here. Right now. So hopefully in a second here we'll be able to see a cooling difference. While I'm waiting for this to charge the system, I'll talk a little bit about this trainer real got here at JTEC. It's the exact system out of the 98 Audi A4 with a 2.8. And what's really great about this is you can see the fuses right here for the system. You can pull fuses and see how that changes the system. If you want to cause a problem, you got a little fault box here with switches. And it's got this nice little plate so you can see the different problems that you can cause in the system, see how that will affect the system. So us as technicians can get a better idea of what it looks like when those parts go bad. What's really great about this machine over here is you can see it's got an automatic button when it does your evac and recharge port, and it just starts going through the steps as it should. Pulls all the refrigerant out for you, pulls the vacuum so you can get some leak detection. And then you can also charge the unit back up with Perfomance, so you don't have to have the hoses and sit there and shake the pan. And it's got a nice digital display, it'll tell you how much Perfomance is in it. Right there, and it's got scales in it, so you can measure different weights of Perfomance. It's got your gauges so you can check your pressures, and then it's also got a oil bottle so that if you're low on oil in your system, you can fill that back up so you don't lose a compressor and you have to replace that, because sometimes they can be pretty costly. Doesn't want to charge. Sometimes this machine is touchy. I think I'm going to have to go back here and hit the charge button and actually put it in the full size. If I remember correctly, I believe my instructor told me that I do, in fact, have to get both on this machine for it to actually want to charge. Pretty quick what we got here. So we'll try the volt button this time to see if we can actually get some Perfomance in this system. Hopefully this machine will work this time. If I can't, I'll direct your attention over here while I'm waiting for that. As you may have seen in one of my other videos, I haven't been going on the board to show you how the AC system works. It's a pretty good example of how it goes from the compressor, built pressure, goes through the condenser, works just like your radiator, works up in the refrigerant, goes up, and then hit your orifice tube, which you can start on the low side, which will cause that pressure to go through. Like I said, that's where the maximum flow goes right there. Move back over here and see if it's charged up again. I really want to show you what it looks like though. Hopefully with that 4 ounces, that compressor will turn on and we can see temperature differential. And hopefully that answers some of your questions as to why your AC may not work. But it does not look like the machine is going to do that, so I'm going to end the video now.